and cleared out this entire... Oh, hello. I've cleared out that entire area up there of dirt. I have more dirt than I think I've ever had in my bags at once. God, well, there's one more. I'll fix that up later. I cleaned out this entire area so that I could build my farm, and because it is a little over 300 units. Now, I have a problem. I forgot that I need a bucket. I need to have a bucket to carry some water. So what we need to do is we need to go cave diving for just a brief bit so that I can get... Oh, what am I doing? So I can go ahead and get a bucket. Because I need a Heza bucket. And what the hell am I doing? Why do I want wood? I don't want wood. Well, I mean, yeah. Okay. All right. Here, ready? Okay, before we go, I'm going to drop off all this dirt because I don't need it right now. So let's go ahead, toss it in. Yeah. See, do I have it? Yeah, okay. Let's put some dirt away. And let us deposit this cobblestone, because I don't really need that much cobblestone. By the way, I found something really cool. I got some cobblestone out of that quarry over there. Now, the interesting thing is what is actually right beyond this quarry. And I will wait. Build up, drum roll. We have a ravine, a really deep ravine, actually. Holy crap. And there's some iron right over there. Actually, we could probably just go get that iron and be good with it. So, thank you. There are so many chickens here. Like, oh my god, there's chickens everywhere. Okay, enough chicken noises. There are so many, like this seed has so many cool things in it. How did you get over them, Mr. Chicken? I don't know. I need to get over there. Because I want that iron. Where did that iron go? Okay, it's over there. Let's, actually, there's some iron right there. I could do this the easy way, but it's me, so let's do it the hard way. I need to dig straight down right there. Let's go. One block at a time. Chicken's looking at me like, oh, you're some kind of crazy. So crazy. And then I'm like, I don't care. I live for danger. Let's see. Okay, it's right there. So let's dig over here. Okay. Let's dig too wide because I don't want to fall to my death. That would be a really unfortunate situation. Oh, hey, right here. I don't know, let's see. We dig around it first. Just to make sure we're not digging ourselves into a sticky situation. But yeah, I'm enjoying doing these videos quite a bit. I hope you guys are as well. I have a lot of other plans for different Minecraft series, depending on how much I continue to pursue this. Depending on if you guys like, wow, there's iron everywhere. I have already started doing a small map on the side just to, one, enjoy a Minecraft map outside of this LP, but also because I'm testing to see if I actually want to do it. I have been looking at the Atlantis survival map. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with it. It's actually quite popular. And basically what it is you're put like 300 blocks down in the ocean. And you have no tools, no nothing, except for a small satchel of supplies in this little chest. And you're in this little dome, this glass dome underneath all this water, and you have to survive. And it is actually pretty difficult. Like, I played survival maps before, and some of them can be hard, some of them can be kind of like a joke. I haven't done Skyblock yet. I have seen people do it before, though, because most LPers will probably tell you that they actually started off by watching LPs themselves. So I've definitely done that. And so that's something I would be interested in looking at. If you guys are too, let me know. so I can kind of gauge the interest level. But yeah. So let's go ahead. I'm going to put those in there real quick. And then we will get some iron for a bucket. In the meantime, let's organize the inventories. I don't really have much to do. I'm going to throw away this wooden junk. I don't like that in my inventory. I'm OCD about that. I'm wasted. I'm wasteful, okay? Sue me. All right. So, yeah, basically onto the idea for the farm is that it requires one bucket, a hoe. I think I might need actually I might make two hoes. I don't know how actually I'll probably make three. I don't no, actually I think two would be good. I forgot how much you require, or at least how much is taken up, but basically what we want to end up doing is just using one thing of water. We're going to like supply a huge amount of food. And the way it's done is I didn't realize before that actually if sorry, I have a short attention span. Come here. Come here. Don't fly away. Come back. Screw you. Jeez. I don't want to kill you anyways. Anyways, so Jesus. This is what I mean by short attention span, because I still need to pick up some water. Actually, I think there's some water right over here. So basically, I did not realize that running water counts as a saturated block. And so the goal of this is to basically use one water source and end up fielding that many seed cubes. So let's go ahead and get back to our field, and we'll go ahead and get started. I don't know if it's exactly long enough. I have a surplus of dirt that I can fill back in and basically extend this area out over here if need be. I didn't actually do the. You know what? It might be too small. But that's okay. I can fix it and I can cut it and do it off camera if need be. So let's go ahead and get started. This looks like about halfway. So, okay, so here's the idea. Let's go ahead and put this here. Let's grab that block. There's your water. So what we need to do is we are going to break seven. I believe it's seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, so yeah, you basically want to do it until you reach the end of the flow. And let's go ahead and fill that flow spot back in. Okay, so now we want to do that in every direction from the source block. So here, here, and here. So that's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, the shovel. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. The shovel's. Actually, I think it'll survive. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, so this is not going to be big enough from this area and that area. So I will do those later, but I'll show you what I'm doing first so you guys can understand, and then you won't have to be here for the whole damn thing. So basically, here's the end. What we want to do is from this end point, we want to go out one, two, three, four, okay? On all sides, like all directions. So we have four there, four there, four there. You also want to get the diagonals. Okay? So basically, you don't really have to do it this way, but it's a really good way to measure out your distance. Okay? So this entire area is like this. And you want to go around each section and do this. It's kind of a good way to judge distance from. Let's see, wait. One, two, three, four. It's a good way to basically do the groundwork for this design. Two, three, four. Did I do that right? Yeah, I did. That one's too small. There we go. Okay, so three, four. Okay, it's kind of too bad that You can't see the re- Actually, you know what, real quick. I still have some stuff to show you with that, but it's getting dark and I'm scared. And I don't want them to ruin my poor field over there. I'm gonna have to. I'll make some walled protection eventually. But for now, I just want to get the groundwork built and then have some steady food supply. Because I don't want to constantly keep killing these chickens. I love these chickens. They've been very supportive of me. They're the only reason why I'm still alive here, because of their wonderful chicken breasts. So let's keep doing this. You know what? Actually, I can show you right now before I switch off camera. Let's fill in this area. Yeah. I'll make it more pretty later. I just want to fill this in so I have dirt. Because I need lots of dirt. All right. That should be good. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to do this on all sides, the pattern that I'm doing. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Why do I keep making this one too short? 1, 2, 3. I hope I'm doing this right. I think I am, anyways. Sure. Did I jump there? I think I jumped there. Yeah, because those ones are staying. Or did I make this too big? I think it's good. All right, I'm back real quick. I actually was off by one block. What I ended up doing is I have to actually start from this block, and I was actually just to make it easier. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You got those. Now before I went from starting here, but actually you're supposed to start from here. So that's why a few of them weren't getting the they weren't getting saturated. So this fixed it. I already fixed the other. Is that good? Yeah, okay, that's good. So I already fixed the other one over there just to show you what it's supposed to look like. Okay, so once you have the framework built out for these, what you want to do is you want to fill in each section within the lines that you built. Okay, so it's like I said before, it's just like building a foundation to a house. It's just a good habit. Whoops. It's just a good habit to get into just so that you make sure to always plan out your work beforehand. And that's basically what this is supposed to do. All right, so now that these are done, you want to make sure to do it to both all sides. You want to come in and connect these, just like that. It's very symmetrical. You're into, and then meet in the center. You want to do it to all sides. And once that's done, you till the inside. Okay, so once that's all tilled, this entire area is going to be plantable ground. Likewise, you can do it on the whole other side, and I'm about to show you some magic. Hwah! All right, I'm back. As you can see, I've completely cleared out this area, and it is slowly becoming completely saturated. So this is, I mean, it's a really simple method, obviously. You can create multiple layers if you would like. It's pretty simple. You just simply take out this top. I don't want to do it right now because I don't want the saturation to go away. But actually, you know what? I probably could just because I don't have nearly enough seeds. So basically, what you would do is you do this. Let's just take this out. You can knock out this block. It has, or excuse me, not this block. Take that one back in. This one right here, where the water edge ends, then this creates a new pathway for the water. It creates a new set. So then, if we were to do this, your water would keep on going. And again, you could continue to do this pretty much indefinitely. So once you put that away, well, then that's it. So that is a wonderful method. You can literally make this based off of one block to go to the bottom of this game, if possible. It's possible. So what I'm gonna what I'm where did you Okay, so what I'm gonna do real quick is I only have 24 seeds, so I'm gonna plant sections first. So let's start from the closest end. No real particular reason. Yeah, let's do this section. Plant here. Just keep on going. Cool. So now I will be able to have some quality food eventually. I'm gonna go ahead and put a bunch of torches around here just for the sake of keeping some stuff away and just keeping it in general bright, high light level during nighttime. I can, actually, what I probably will do is create some floating blocks eventually. I might do something rudimentary right now. Yeah, how far out do I want to go? See, is that is this what I want to do? Sure. Actually, you know what I could probably do instead? Let's already planted these. I guess I can just do it like this. There we go. Okay. Have that like that. And then I'm just having it in the areas facing away from where. Yeah, I think that would be good for now until I need to plant some more. That should be all right. Let's retill that. And we're good. So hopefully this will start producing for us, and that would make me a happy camper. Now let's go ahead and our iron actually is done, so I'm gonna go ahead and make us some more armor. We should probably be able to finish up the rest of our armor. Let's see, we need, what do we still need? Boots and a headpiece. So let's go ahead and make the boots. And then, oh shoot, did I forget how to make the head? Was it? Yes, okay, good. Good. I was about to get embarrassed there for a second. But luckily, we now have a full set of armor! Woo! Which means we can go ahead and start crafting more objects. I already destroyed this iron pickaxe from excessive use in getting a bunch of cobblestone that I'm going to be using later to build a wall for my farm over there. So this should be good for now. Oops, let's go click that. And let's go ahead and organize this a little bit better. Let's put the almost all the dirt in there. Let's see, do I need to put anything else? Okay, let's put the eggs away. Let's keep this. And I want some more wood just in case I need to make stuff. And that should be good. What we need to do though is we need to craft another axe, because this axe has pretty much had it. So let's grab the axe. I don't really need the shovel as much anymore, or the hoe. I don't think I would use that too much. And let's go ahead and make a sword. Probably a good idea to have two swords on hand, considering we're playing on a hard mode. So let's go and put the bucket back, because I don't want to lose that, and my iron. You know what? I think I'm gonna keep my valuables. I'll move this stuff later because obviously they're not really super valuable. But I'm gonna keep my rare materials in the second one. Actually, you know what? I can make signs for these later, so they're all marked and labeled. So what I want to do is continue. What was that? It was loud. I want to continue checking out these caves. You know, I'm just surprised we haven't left this general area. We haven't needed to. This place is massive. You know, it's just in general, an entire cave system is just right here. Oh, okay. I forgot that, well, that goes underneath there. So let's go ahead and I want to build a nice ramp. I see you, creeper. You're not fooling anybody. Okay. This should be good. Yes. All right. Let's put some cobblestone. No. I like having my torches on my 5 key. Just always how it's been. So, let us venture into the caves. I've been wanting to do this for a while. Oh God. I see spiders. I see an Enderman right there. And I'm hearing some pretty scary stuff. Let's, this shovel is dead. Shoot. I don't have any more shovels. Oh well. No, you're not gonna get me, skeleton. I mean, can you come up here? Am I gonna have to, like, drill you a place to come up? Okay, can you stop hitting me? Damn it! Okay, you should be able to come up it so I can at least hit you. Right? Come on, asshole. Shit. Okay, whatever. Oh shit. Blow up, blow up! Damn it! What, my sword broke! Okay, that's a good opportunity. Okay, we're good. Oh god, I stared at him. I stared at him. I hate that noise. Oh my. Oh, there's more! Okay, we're gonna have to seriously stop things from spawning. Did you guys see that? Look how deep this goes and how far it goes. Oh my god. It's like the definition of both long and thick. I'm scared that this pick is going to run out right when I need it most. Stop it. Jesus. No. Son of a bitch. No, damn it! Back! Shit, another one! Jesus Christ! Where are they coming from? Back! I'll hit you with my chicken! Jesus. Okay. Really need to light this up. Yes, I saw the guy. I'll come back and get you. Yeah, I saw you, villager. You know, if there's a villager here, that must mean. Oh god, those little pygmy shits. Come here, fuck! Yeah! Jesus, where are these guys spawning from? I'm concerned my swords are going to run out. I probably should have got more than 2 swords. So. Oh my god, full gold armor. And I'm low on health. Let's get out of here and recharge a little bit. Well, it seems that caving is going to be very dangerous. What? Who's hitting me? Are you like Katniss Everdeen or something? This is absurd. I hit every shot. It's like cat. Ha. What I really need to do is get some diamond so that I can start a enchanting table. I really need an enchanting table. That would be lovely. What? No, not more of these guys. Jesus, if I die, swear to God. Oh my God. Okay. Shit, 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 shit. Ah! What is that? Oh, I thought. Okay, never mind. Okay. We're gonna go mine some stuff in the back. I'll re-regenerate some health. I actually do need coal. Oh my god! Fuck! God! Did you hear that noise? Oh, it's nighttime, of course. Jesus. Jesus. Whatever. Whatever. It's okay. It's cool. I'll get my shit back. Still mad. Still upset. You know what I'm saying? I should have looked at the time, but I didn't. And at least I'm not too far down. You know what I'm saying? Because if I was really far down, oh man, I'd be mad. Super mad, actually. But he like came out of nowhere. He's like, hey, what's up, brah? Let me, do you have a word to talk about Jesus? You have a word to talk about fucking Jesus? I want to talk to you about Jesus! Boom! And that's what happens, kids, when people want to talk to you about Jesus. Killed by a fucking creeper. Okay. Oh, breathe. Woosa. Okay, I don't want that pick. I want this pick. I hate dying. I have never died this much in Minecraft. But as I said before, I have also never done hard mode before either. So that probably has something to do with it. Let's see, I feel like I'm missing something that's supposed to be on my bars. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Yeah, let's wait a second. What I need to do is, like, are there mods that are, like, detection? It's kind of cheating. I didn't want to do this with mods because I just wanted to, I mean, I'm not saying mods are cheating or anything like that. I'm just saying that, I just wanted to do this completely vanilla. So, I mean, minus my texture pack because I love this texture pack and I can't go back to the default one. I'm actually thinking about maybe picking up a new texture pack. I've had this one since forever. So, which would be cool. I like new textures. The modding community for Minecraft is absolutely phenomenal. Okay. Is that? Let me see. There's nothing in here. No. I don't think so. Okay. I gotta say, though, that playing Minecraft on hard is definitely much more, I wouldn't say interesting, but stressful. Stressful. All right, I'm gonna take you on. I need to start getting my pearls. Fuck you! Yeah! What? I probably should have waited until I had an iron sword. But that's okay. Come on. I'm right here. Oh, but right where I, shit, I don't know. I'm starting to have low health. Oh, Jesus. No, one of those little things. Fuck. Where'd it go? Can it come in here? Oh, shit! Okay, because this is like, this is too small for him to spawn. So let's come over here real quick. I hear you above me or something. Come fight me like a man. Is he gonna spawn? Or am I just gonna, like, have done all that for nothing? Probably gonna end up. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Shit! Aha! And you drop nothing. Dude, holy shit, I, like, jumped out of my seat. Oh my god. Is there. I feel like there's a creeper. Just creeping. That's just a bat. That's good. I don't need creepers right now. Okay, how much iron do I have? I have 19. Okay, I really need to start making better weapons. I kind of want to go back before I get myself killed. But, oh Jesus, I heard that. What is that? Okay, no, that was nothing. Never mind. Sorry. Okay, more iron. Okay, let's check what's down here. Just clear out this place of some iron. And we will probably head back. And I want to go to sleep. I want to see if my crops have yielded anything good. Not yet. Anyways, I just want to see the check up on the progress. Because what I need to do is, I'm probably going to only be using 10% of my harvest for myself, at least in the beginning, And then from there, I will be using the rest to, seed the area, which would be good. Because I really need to fill that out. Didn't mean to run. Okay, so this place is cleared out. Nothing should spawn in here, which is, this is going to be good. I know I said before I didn't have any plans to make a mob grinder, but I might. If you guys have any recommendations for a good working mob grinder for 1.6.2, that's a version that I'm on right now, then let me know. I heard a zone. I heard that. Okay. But yeah, if you guys have any recommendations, send me the a link to YouTube or something, and I will check it out, and if I end up using it, I will shout you out on my channel. Okay, let's not like that means anything. I mean, I got 100 subs. I love you guys. But, I mean, if you want a shout out from me, it's kind of like, I will do it, but you just have to rein in those expectations. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and do this. Let's get the rest of this coal. I mean, there's just so much here to explore. I'm usually right now, at this point in Minecraft, I have, I'm pretty settled in. And I'm at the point where I kind of want to move on to a new area just because either I've got my main stuff done or I've exhausted just the outlying caverns. Or may I wouldn't exactly say moving on, I would say have exhausted of the caverns that are just in sight. Right? Not the ones that you have to dig yourself. Did I miss this? How did I miss that? But yeah, so let's we'll go ahead and explore down that area later. Let's get the rest of this iron. And we will go. Let's go ahead and start smelting. But don't forget, we're still in nighttime. So we're gonna have to run through all those sons of bitches. Yeah, I see you. I'm waiting for you. You can't hide from me, so shit! He started early. Whatever. Kill yourself. See if I care. There's some iron right there. Whatever. We can get it later. It's not like it's going anywhere. Let's dig this out. Need to make a better ramp upstairs. So. So what should I do? It's a really shitty. Okay, let's Oh, but damn it! No, bad. There. This is more like it. We go. Perfect. Nice little stairway. I mean, it doesn't look anything beautiful, but it does the job. I see you. Are those? Oh, he has enchanted boots. Nice. I have never had a zombie actually drop something for me that was worthwhile. So it'd be nice if I actually could get something to drop. I'm talking about like pieces of armor. I saw a post on Reddit earlier today where this guy got a diamond drop from a zombie, and I was like, "What the fuck? That's crazy." I mean, I congratulated him, but I was jealous as shit. How is he still? Why isn't the fire burning him? Block! Good luck that did. Hua! Give me some of your butter! Damn, the knockback is crazy. Aw, two bones. But I hit level 10, which is good. Start getting my points up. Okay, cool. They're coming along quite nicely. None of them have fully matured yet. This one's the closest. So hopefully they will grow faster. Okay, so let's go see what we need to do before we call this. All right. So did I put anything here to cook? No. I have 41 ore, which is great. Probably gonna need to add more coal So let's go ahead and add you. And then we can actually start building some quality weapons. I can get rid of all of this nonsense. So I think that that's going to be it for this episode, guys. I really appreciate you watching my videos. If you have any feedback, go ahead and leave it. I'd love to hear from you. Again, if you know any working mob grinder that is relatively simple, let me know in the comments below. Anyways, this is Byronic, and that is it.